What's up, YouTube? So this is one of these paint brushes. It's for painting corners, and I found one. I think it's from Home Depot or something, but you can just search for them. Depends on the store. So it has very, very thin hairs, a lot of them. And also the hairs are not that soft, so they are not very stiff, but they aren't soft either, so it's just in between. And I think this is one of the best tools that will just get inside the tiny, tiny grooves to clean and everything cleanly. This is the bag. It gives you an idea. Perhaps there was two of them on this. I don't know what there's like a brand on it, but you can find this everywhere inside a paint section, hardware stores. It says for corners. This is a record. I can say it's a new record. It's a newly bought record, because obviously most of the records these days are bought used. And it has like was like a something was like poured something with liquids in there. There's dust on it, and so I'm going to give it a try. And I do use, I don't know, it's really necessary, but I put like one part alcohol, isopropyl 70%, and 4 or 5 parts water. I had this tiny spray. I would not spray directly on the vinyl on the record, because it just doesn't dry fast enough. Just spray over the... My advice is try to use it for the first time or first tries on a record that you don't really like, that you don't really care about it, just to see if there is any change in the sound. I started doing this with one of my favorite records, and I overdid spin this thing on the record, and also I put too much pressure on it, and I did play back the record, and it feels to me that the sound kind of lost, maybe lost, I would call this lost color or lost volume, not loudness, just the volume, or maybe a 3D effect. It wasn't that much of a full sound. Maybe into the tiny, tiny grooves, this brush, because of too much pressure, kind of scraped the surface of the groove. Sometimes they may put kind of a coat over the vinyl, and that material being removed by forcing too much with this brush, maybe it did remove the friction, you know, the friction on the stylus that will cause the stylus to vibrate locally, and that may have removed the quality of the sound, the volume, the color. So if you try to use these brushes, my advice is spin it only a few times. Don't try to make thinking you are going to really scoop into the grooves and remove everything possible there. Don't try to overdo it, and also don't apply pressure on it. So don't put your hand with force on it. I would just, I'm doing this just on my bed here. So you just may want to cover the entire length. And if you actually push with your finger, but without pressure actually, you'll see it does follow the grooves. Basically, it's like, it's a little bit like a toy, like a, if you want a little train or something like this, it really goes by itself. And I will only try to maybe give it a few turns like this. This is a record that I just bought. Obviously, it's used, it's from a secondhand store. But even just a few turns like this without pressing down, and with that spray on it, it should give you quite a clean surface. If you can see it, all the dust, it does remove all the dust, it does clean the surface very nicely. It does make the vinyl appear darker, just like it's new. It's not going to do miracle. If you have fingerprints or grease or something like that, you may want to try with something else. Try a towel, try something with cotton, so you don't put electricity, static electricity that attracts actually more dust. It's not going to do miracles, but it does bring you that nice shine to the disc. And if you follow, just not try to overdo it, I think it's a very useful thing. Try not to touch it with your fingers, and I will keep it like that, so it doesn't get too much dust on it when it stays on the side. but it's a nice tool, and I think it's pretty useful for these discs.